Florida is known as the fishing capital of the world, but right now there's a lot less fishing and a lot more concern about what's happening to their valuable and vulnerable ecosystem. If you walk up and down Indian River Lagoon, you will see this. Thousands of dead fish belly up in the water. There are several different factors going into play here. One is the state received about triple their average rainfall for the month of January. All of that rainwater and runoff has gone straight into the rivers and the lagoon. Not to mention, because of El Nino, temperatures were warmer than normal, allowing for a toxic algae bloom and brown tide to take over. The algae bloom depletes the oxygen from the water, in turn killing the fish, and has also killed more than half the lagoon's seagrass. The Florida Fish and Wildlife Research Institute says the fish kills happen all the time, all over the state. But this one is massive. Farther south, there's another problem. Lake Okeechobee is the highest it's been in 10 years. So right now, the Army Corps of Engineers is draining it. Billions of gallons of fresh water pouring out of Lake Okeechobee, this brackish water affecting the salinity of all the estuaries. The Army Corps of Engineers says that they are backing off to a safer discharge. But if you ask the fishermen in the area, they say it's too little, too late.
So will the sea recover? According to a study from 2006, 10 years ago, the loss of ocean life was accelerating. And if the long-term trend continued, in 20 years from now, today, there will be little or no more seafood available for sustainable harvest. And 30 years from now, seafood may be gone. If you'd like to subscribe, please click on the link.